Hey, folks, it's Urban Grower, and we're here with Chives and Darcy. How's it going?
Excellent.
And you know what time it is?
Supercharge time.
And for that, we've got some killer buds here. Let me grab the camera and show you exactly what we're talking about. This stuff is unreal, folks. Here it is. UBC Chemo Kush. Bam. That stuff looks fucking nuts. Unbelievable weed.
Smells good, too.
Good stuff.
Oh, yeah. No, it's crazy.
A little bit excited here, not going to lie.
And then we got some goo goodness. Look at that. It changed color a little bit because I was heating it up. We got some hash that I made myself. And this came from the Pollen Master from CETA. Got a couple balls of hash. We're going to throw that in.
Now, would that be considered hash or would that be considered keef, though?
I'd consider it hash because it's all stuck together.
Okay.
The next thing we got is butter. Look at that. And what kind of butter is this, Chives?
That would be some of the Chemo Kush butter with Rockstar, actually.
Nice.
Yes.
Sounds killer.
It tastes amazing.
Can't wait to try that. And then we got the Urban Grower Grinder. And for the first time ever with the Urban Grower Grinder, we got, here, I'm going to open this up and we grab that camera. We got our first collection of crystal, folks. Ready to see this?
Oh, I can't wait.
Okay,
I've been working at this for a while now.
This is for the entire Kush cup. I ground all the strains that were in the cup, plus probably a half pound of extra weed. And this is what we got. Ready?
Okay, let's see.
One, two, three, I'll be getting close.
Holy. Wow.
That's unreal.
That makes my eyes red just looking at it. You know
amazing.
That?
Yep.
That's
unreal.
That looks like some fine powder, but don't snort it. It'd be a bad thing.
I'm feeling truly spoiled. I've actually seen somebody do that before. It's funny for everybody but the guy who does it.
It would be really painful.
Yeah.
We got the Timmy Hose here. Let's get to work. Oh, I gotta have Tim's.
Gotta have Tim's.
I learned in Amsterdam that coffee and cannabis, they go together. They both start with C for one thing.
It all kind of evens itself out.
One makes you sleepy, one wakes you up.
Exactly.
It's a yin and yang.
It's the yin and yang.
Look at that stuff there. Doesn't that look nuts?
Oh, I can't wait.
It's beautiful. So I'll grind that up. Maybe I'll hand the grinder over to Chives here. And we're going to start on the paper. Has anybody got a light?
No, these grinders work.
You got a light?
Better.
Perfect.
The most grinders I've tried before. I think it's the fact that you guys didn't anodize here.
Here you go.
Yeah, it's the brand new Urban Grower Online grinder available from Urban Grower Online.
Nice. That.
We were selling these things at the Health Expo, and they're very popular. They got more teeth in them. They got a 3D logo. They're just kick ass.
They're also a lower profile than most grinders I've seen, and they fit in your pocket better.
Yeah, they do.
They do. I really enjoy that about mine.
Look at that.
Oh my.
Good goodness.
And you know, it's a great name for it. I had the pleasure of trying this stuff once at the expo there in the sublimator. And it was really, really tasty. The guy knows his stuff.
You know what I'm going to do? This vial is getting very, very warm. I'm going to put this, twist this up and wrap this around this.
There's another little Boy Scout tip.
That's right, another innovation from a stoner.
Jar is hot.
I did that on the fly here.
That's right. See, it doesn't take away from the thought process. It just
I didn't want to burn my
changes
fingers.
The thought process.
Now, what strain did you use to make this keef or hash?
That one there?
Yeah.
Oh, that's actually Bubba Kush. Oh, nice. We got some Bubba Kush.
Now, is
blonde
that
hash.
The whole vial of oil in that joint?
Half a vial.
Yeah, it appears
oh,
to be.
Half
a vial.
Oh, my goodness. Oh my.
This joint should destroy you.
I think it just might, you know, when most people say supercharged, you get a little bit of some rub in there, a little bit of keef in there. But when you say supercharged, I should have known better.
We're all in.
I almost should have signed a waiver.
Now this should be the most potent supercharged joint ever. A mega supercharged joint. Mega supercharged.
First ever.
Yeah, I would say the first. No, other people may have done this before, but have they lived to tell the story? That's the question.
Well, you know what? If you don't get high off this joint, I quit. I'm getting rid of all my ballast and grow lights. I'm packing it in. All
right.
That's it. Okay, that's the vial right there. I think that's
That's definitely
pretty empty. I don't want to touch that. Look at that.
The whole vial down.
I'm just going to fold this now. spread that, try to even it out. Wow. This paper feels heavy. Feels nice. There's weight to the paper, folks.
There's weight. See,
that's the heaviest paper in the world.
We can just smoke the paper and we'll probably be fine.
See, that's unreal how clear it is. You can still see it. Still fingers right through the paper.
Like, goodness all the way. Like, I'm not an oil person myself. You know me, I'm the butter guy. I really like the extracts once they've been taken a little bit further. But that goo goodness is absolutely amazing. It is the exception to my rule. I'll smoke this and happily so.
Look at this. Look at that oil slick. Like the Exxon Valdez there. Yummy. I think it's time to throw a layer of keef in there.
I don't think anybody's going to argue.
Uh-oh.
So now,
out.
I'm guessing this is to help it so that the rest of the weed doesn't stick to the oil that you've put in. By doing the keef first, you give a nice little buffer there to make it sort of roll nicely.
Sure. We'll go with that.
Well, I think it's going to work that way. Although, that's a lot of keef, so I don't know.
I'll try to spread that out.
I think the theory was sound right up until it got about a half an inch thick.
That is a thick layer. Look at this. This layer would make Tony Montana proud.
So again, we now have enough to not require anything else and still sufficiently be high with each one of those additives. So I'm getting a little scared now.
Well, that's not even all the keef. Look at this. If we scrape that down, which I will, because that's the whole point of the supercharged joint, is to smoke all that shit. But I think it's time for a layer of weed. What do you think?
I'm wondering if there's going to be room for weed. That's what I'm wondering. You know what? I know you. You'll make room.
This might be the only supercharged joint we've ever rolled that doesn't burn. We'll see, though.
We'll see.
Hopefully you get enough weed in it that it'll burn.
Yeah. Okay. Well, now, I think...
We'll put a layer of weed in now.
Yeah. Just a little bit looser might be the trick for some airflow. I mean, how loose will we be able to make it? There's so much in there that has to fit.
Layer of weed, I'll squish that down. It's hash time, people.
Oh,
nice. We're going to break some hash and do it.
That's the Bubba Kush hash.
Nice.
Look at that blonde right in the middle. And you know the whole secret to making this hash is tumbling the buds, because I use small buds to make this when it's fresh, because the trichomes still contain a little bit of moisture and you can just press it into balls with your fingers.
Makes a lot of sense.
And that's how it stays blonde. And look at this, it's pliable. See that? It's like goo.
So now that right there, you've just actually answered the earlier question, what's the difference between this and keef? Keef is after you've already dried the plant out, the trichomes have already gotten brittle and they're no longer sticking together. You're not getting that pliability.
Oh no, that's it'd still be considered keef. Just if you want it to stick together, like example, if you were to try to tumble buds or shake that's like a year old, you'll get some powder off of it, but it'll be like flour. It'd be hard to make it stick, so you're gonna have to get some heat to it and maybe some oil or something. I've almost got the whole ball in here. Pull the hair out of there. That looks fucking insane.
That looks absolutely nuts.
That ball looks like about 2 grams of hash there, no?
I'm not sure how. We should have weighed it.
It's like 1.5 to 2 grams.
You know what we're going to do is we're going to weigh this joint.
That's a good
Before
idea.
We put the filter in, we're going to weigh the joint. We'll see what we're looking at. I think there's going to be a bit in here.
And now the
okay. Body. Well, I gotta put more crystal.
Oh,
crystal.
More crystal.
Look at that. We're gonna put the rest of the crystal in. Might want to get right in here.
So the Kush Cup crystal.
Yeah.
Kush Cup crystal.
And everybody, you know, that's a real special treat there, because this year we had some fantastic entries.
Oh, good.
We really
Way
did.
Better than last year.
Yeah. It really stepped up.
You have to watch the video. You can see what we're dealing with.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely. Watch the videos, because everybody really brought it to the competition this year, and we had a lot of beautiful treats to sample. It was really hard to make the choice this year.
Butter. Man, I'm starting to sweat already.
Yeah,
I haven't even smoked this joint.
It's hot in the sun.
I think it's the preparation and the anticipation. Let's get into everybody.
Okay, I want to get right in here because we're going to start sprinkling this in.
Oh.
Okay, there it is.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to try to roll that up. What do you think?
A lot of fun.
I think that is definitely going to be entertaining.
Yeah. We want to get a close-up of that. Holy shit,
folks.
So there's
amazing.
Wow.
That's all going to go.
You know, now, how much would that joint be worth?
I don't know if you could put $1 million.
That's pretty hard.
$1 million doobie. We'll put it on eBay and find out. Well, maybe that's not such a good idea. That'd be considered trafficking.
We're not gonna do that. And then we wouldn't get to smoke all the hard work you just put in. So we'll smoke it and call it worth every penny.
I'm having trouble picking it up.
Because it's so heavy.
It's the giant joint. Oh my god. That is a rainbow plethora of goodness.
I'm just trying to compress it. I don't want to drop all the weed out of here. There isn't very much weed in here this time. Minimal weed.
But there's a lot of weed product.
Every little bit to burn.
A lot of extract.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? If this joint doesn't work, we're just going to get the bong out and smoke in the bong. What do you think?
That works for me.
It will be consumed.
Uh-oh, the dog's crying.
She wants some too.
No doobie for you.
No doobie for the dog.
Okay, it's time for the filter. I got it rolled. Can you believe it?
Amazing.
We need that scale.
Yeah. Okay, I'll go get the scale. All right. Just got to clean up.
I'll make a filter while you're getting a scale.
All right. I'll be right back.
So now, we found there's a really cool trick with these filter packs. If you tear them halfway down, mm-hmm. you can then flip them up like this, flip them in half to elongate your paper. You can then do the accordion fold to stop the weed from falling out in the middle.
With the same piece.
And you can do the circle fold to expand your doobie and hold it in place. And
Always keep
the shape all from one piece of paper.
Good idea. Always inventive.
Okay, I got my center gram balance from Whole House, just like the ones they used to give us in school.
The old tried and true.
Remember these things from school?
Well, I think everybody does.
Okay, without the filter. This is just the rolling paper and our product. Well, it weighs something. It weighs more than a gram. it weighs more than 2 grams.
Not surprised.
No.
Oh.
It weighs more than 3 grams. Look at this. Uh-oh. Get right in here.
No, I'm a little bit
it's over
now.
3 fucking grams. Okay, here we go.
I think.
Should we put bets on the point here? Is it 3.5? Is it
3.4?
Oh, we're at 3.4 and it's going down. Just under 3.4 to see.
So that's very close to an eighth of an ounce.
That's
joint.
Almost an eighth.
3.3. We're at 3.25 right now.
So it's a half a doobie off an eighth.
3.24 by the looks of it.
Hot smokers out there.
3.24 grams.
For marijuana conversion, it's half a joint less.
That's unreal. Okay, this is one of the heaviest supercharged joints ever, that's for sure.
Wow.
Put the filter in there, I'll get rid of the scale.
All right.
I don't want the neighbors to get the wrong idea.
Yes, folks, the scale is purely for personal
curiosity.
Yeah, we like to know what the hell we're doing to ourselves. Don't get the wrong idea. Why it's an old triple beam and not a digi.
You need a scale because you got to know how much you got, right?
You always have to know.
When I go out, I want to know that I'm not exceeding my limit, which is 600 grams.
Indeed, a responsible patient.
Okay, it's almost supercharge time.
The circle and the accordion gives you a full coverage.
What'd you do?
Smoking the circle with the accordion.
You know what? There's a gap in there. I'm going to add one more little accordion in there.
I think that's a good call.
See the gap?
It will work with most joints. I've never actually rolled a filter for a 3.5 gram joint before.
It's going to have to be a big filter.
It will have to be a big filter.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Prost. All right, that might be too much filter, so I'll give it to you.
Perfect. This is the way I like to start every morning. Actually, that's too much filter.
That's what I thought.
And a perfect morning it is to be doing this.
Beautiful.
Beautiful BC weather again.
So don't get the wrong idea. We put up with a lot of rain.
Now, the sun comes out every time I roll these joints. You don't want to come in here?
Absolutely.
It's time to medicate. You ready? There it is. I'm pre-sweating already. I'm sweating and we haven't even smoked anything yet.
I'm beyond excited.
Okay, here we go. Supercharge time.
Oh, it looks like it's burning.
Burning.
looks like a Trolloz too.
Looks like a Trolloz too. And I'm not shocked at all. He is quite experienced at yeah. this game.
If anybody was going to make wow. that burn,
it would be the man right here. So
it just tastes like solid hash. I don't want to let it go. It tastes that good. That might possibly be the best supercharged joint ever.
That is amazing.
The best supercharged joint I've ever rolled in my life.
You've already got a resin line around your top.
And it just got lit.
Crazy. I was afraid it wasn't going to burn.
No fear in that.
I'm afraid it's going to burn forever. Oh, wow.
It's just flavor.
Amazing. It actually feels gooey in your fingers.
Oh, dude, like it's, literally, my like ass it's off Play-Doh. That is good.
Well, that's almost an eighth of an ounce in one single paper.
I think camera guy needs
next time, this. We're going to top it. We're going to put an eighth in the next time. We can get 3.5 grams and everything.
I think
this tastes
more
amazing, and it's amazing how easy on the draw it is. It doesn't harsh out the throat.
I was
smooth.
Expecting a choke. I was expecting with everything you threw in there to at least be doing a little bit of the
really easy to take big
after every pop, and that is
you know what we should have done. That's nice. We should have weighed the hash and everything as we put it in. Next time.
Next time. These are the things you think about.
An analysis of the joint.
The CSI breakdown.
It's fucking smooth.
It's
amazing.
Ridiculous.
It is.
We should be truly. Choking in all theory. We should be gagging on this.
And it's burning unbelievable.
It no run.
The only problem
thank
is.
Thank you so much. This is a treat.
The only problem is it really it's way is. Too sunny out here.
It is getting kind of warm in the sun, yeah.
It is warm in the sun. Now there you go, typical BC attitude. We don't like the rain, but when it gets too hot, we'll complain about that too.
I'm a fair weather stoner, you know that?
Yeah, I like a little bit of overcast, no rain. Nice comfy. Nice comfy temperature. And I can get high and work all at the same time. That is burning ridiculously well. You don't have to fight for that puff either. Usually on a joint like this, you really gotta fight for that puff.
Easy draw.
It's like smoking acid, folks. That is a crazy
it's
joint.
Mushrooms in a doobie.
Everybody gets quiet.
Honestly, I think this is my third draw of this, and I'm getting extremely high already.
Yeah, I'm appreciating the product already. It's
cool.
I'm into the enjoyment phase of the whole. See, look at that.
It's not destroying me. Oh, the camera guy's got to try this out.
I think he does.
Just passing the camera guy.
Camera guy.
Camera guy, go.
3D, so
go, camera guy, go. Go, camera guy, go.
Can't leave anybody out. Like we said the other day, it's all about the love and the sharing.
Well, you know, when you're a cameraman on the Urban Grower Show, you have to smoke the weed. We piss test. Yes. You don't have to make sure that you do take drugs.
Right. That's awesome.
Yeah.
If you don't have enough THC in your system, unfortunately, you have to be let go. It hurts everybody. But we do give you a chance to smoke enough and catch up.
I don't trust people that don't smoke weed.
They tend to be uptight, I find.
Aggressive. Too aggressive.
I agree.
Kind of like those A-team dudes, eh?
Like, that's right. We were having that discussion the other day with the giant joint. Now, this is maybe a lot smaller, but it is much more enjoyable than the giant joint.
Oh, yeah. No, that's way more potent than that giant joint for sure. And it was a giant joint, but it was schwag.
No, but I bet you, with all the keef and all the fucking butter and everything you put in there, the THC equivalent is about the same.
Look how blue the smoke is coming off of there.
Starting to get a little thicker down in the bottom now, but I mean,
it's getting really heavy.
What do you expect with everything that's in there? It's all melting down through, congealing in the bottom. The roach
there's barely any weed in there.
I know. So everything's melting as we smoke.
Yeah.
It's gonna hit a point where it goes.
It's starting to get harder to draw.
Yeah, the roach from that is gonna be a solid mass of.
It'll feel like a stick.
THC,
I bet.
Yeah, let's just poke this hole in here. Look at this.
With the skillet tools.
Okay.
Very handy, handy little things here. This is a Gear brand one, but they're all from Skillets, aren't they?
Look at this.
Yeah, Skillets tools.
Perfect.
Quite handy.
Fixed it, so when it starts to plug up, just give it a little poke with that tool there, and you're back in business.
Back in the game. Awesome.
For those at home that are supercharging and joined to this extreme.
Yes.
Right now,
you don't have to give
up. Do this video. Yeah. You realize it
hopefully
is a term
you people
now
are getting high with us at home right now. Joint? You've done this yourself. You're sitting there. You're smoking with us, and here's.
Holy cow! Yeah, this is like the entire Kush cup in one joint.
One joint. And it actually is, because this is some of the product we had. For the Kush Cup, the butter.
The grinder was clean at the beginning.
Everything from the Kush Cup.
This is what happens to a grinder when you grind more than a half pound of weed through it, and then, here, check this out.
It's looking well-worn already.
And then all the Kush Cup entries, this is what happens to your grinder.
But let's
be clear.
It gets
totally caked.
I cleaned that yesterday.
To what it is now.
What you're seeing is it cleaned. It was so caked that you couldn't get the lid on to turn it.
We need to marinate it in some alcohol.
I think you're correct.
But if you're going to do that, take the little O-ring out.
The O-ring off.
Because it'll fuck it right up. Take the O-ring out. There's a tip for you.
That is the best cleaning tip for those grinders out there, period. Right there.
That O-ring, that little plastic ring gets any alcohol, it swells up, and it becomes oblong, and then it's useless.
It also gets brittle, it'll crack, it'll fall off, and once you lose it, it's too much friction between that metal. It binds up.
Metal on metal.
Metal on metal. Yeah, no, you need that O-ring. That's an awesome tip.
I remember that 80s song, Metal on Metal. What was that band?
Was that Saxon or something?
No, it wasn't Saxon. It was a Canadian band. They had that movie a couple years ago. A documentary movie.
It'll come to me.
Anvil!
Anvil!
For all you metal
heads. He had the wild curly hair.
He did!
Yep.
Yeah.
He was bigger than life character, that guy.
And they actually came and played in Vancouver.
Yep, fairly recently,
yeah,
too. Yeah,
it was a good show.
Still doing the tour, still keeping it real.
Yeah. The obscure rock references from the Stoners. Yes, they still bring it.
Yeah. I had that one tape, because it was the 80s. Tape, not CD.
Yeah, the cassette.
Metal on metal. That's right. Anvil.
You know, it's ridiculous that In one generation, they've gone through three or four different music styles to the point so quickly that the kids don't even understand the ones that we were born with.
I don't know. My kids listen to Zeppelin and Pink Floyd right now.
I find there's a lot of kids listening to throwback music, like 80s tunes.
But it's on CDs.
And 70s stuff.
It's burnt. It's MP3s. Yeah. I'm glad they're listening to the music, though, definitely.
Oh, no, actually, my kid came in here, took all my DVDs. Hey, where's all your Led Zeppelin and old stuff? Where's your fucking Doors? Where's this? Where's that? So I hooked him up. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, it's nice with all the Skrillex and the non-music they have out there. They still have some appreciation for some real music.
They get to hear where their music is.
That's just a different style.
Yeah.
It's just a new way of music. I'm going to poke this thing again.
It's okay.
Getting gummy.
But you got to listen there. You got to be exposed to it.
We're only halfway through the joint here, you know that?
Yeah.
I'm
this is the second
up.
Time we've had to unplug it now, eh?
Well, I know third. Unplugged it. I unplugged it. Okay. He's unplugged it. So I think we should just hand the tool around with the joint now.
Give it a little reaming before
you
take your toad.
Yeah. It's like the chimney sweep.
Oh, yeah. Fuck that smooth. That's amazingly smooth for how much stuff's in there.
Yeah, it remains smooth even down to,
even through
the
end
joint.
Which is, I was, expecting to start choking.
I think we outdid ourselves this time.
Holy jeez.
Fuck, how are we going to top this?
Holy jeez. I think I outclogged it.
Right, nice work, Chuck.
Yeah, got that one.
Yeah,
good work, dude.
Yep.
And you deserved it too.
Oh, wow. Oh. Oh, again, thank you. Wow.
That's just one of the side effects of smoking.
Yeah.
A mega cannabis doobie.
Yeah, you get high when it's clogged, and then you get the magical hoot there. And, wow. I like that. Now, for those who know me, know I have severe ADHD, so the fact that I'm plastered in this chair and really not moving that much, this is good.
Coffee. Now it's getting a little harsh.
Well, it's because I have to open it up.
Be careful.
Really get it.
Handle with care.
May impair your ability to operate machinery, or enhance it in my case.
Well, there was a study. Oh my God! There was a study in Italy, I think.
Blame the Italians?
Blame the Italians. It was Italy or Germany, I'm not 100% sure. But
I don't think it'd be Italy.
It was a
People drive
study.
Hammered there and wine all the time. Those guys are pissed.
Well, maybe that would be the
And I know. I know, folks.
You
I have some of that heritage going on. I don't drink anymore. No, but I used to.
They did a study that's proven that marijuana improves the driving habits of people with ADHD, so people like you and myself, because it takes away from the aggression from when people do silly things. And it also takes away the desire to go quicker than everybody else around you.
How many minutes we at there, camera dude?
24.
No, I mean on the whole video length.
24 minutes.
Holy fuck.
24 minutes are smoking this joint.
Well, I told you, it's going to burn forever.
It is burning forever.
And it looks still like half a joint.
It's almost half a joint. And now that even with the poking and we're getting a good draw, it's still not burning fast. It's
I am sweating
camera,
my balls off.
Did that?
It is warm. What's going to come first? Joint dying or us dying?
No, I will not be defeated
by
the doobie.
It won't be the doobie that defeats us. It will be the sun.
That's a different problem altogether.
We can, and the doobie can come with us.
But you know what we're doing right now?
We'll protect the doobie too.
By smoking this weed, we're like making a creative dome of smoke around us that will filter out some of that UV radiation.
Yes, yes.
Maybe help replenish the ozone. I doubt that. But anyway.
This was stoner sunblock.
Stoner sunblock. Smoke a joint. Like
make
a big cloud.
Make a
huge cloud.
Heavy enough around you
That's
that
right.
you don't get hit by the rays
That's
of
right.
the sun.
And
it seems to be working. Look.
Pay no attention to the scientific facts that state that the sun comes through stronger in smoggy areas. Because that's irrelevant here. This is a different type of smog.
Look at that. That's fucking awesome.
That is nice.
Couldn't have a nicer spot doing this.
I can hear the sizzle every time I take a draw.
Of all the extracts melting, boiling, frothing. And
it's special.
Oh yeah, it's special. Smooth. Shit, after this is done, we're just going to have to smoke a normal joint just to mellow out.
Take
the edge
normal
off.
Feel.
That's right. True potheads chase cannons with more cannons.
Indeed. Hear, hear. Holy cow. The doobie to end all doobies.
It is.
Oh, well, it's actually early. This is the doobie to start my day.
But we already smoked a bunch of doobies before this doobie. Those are just primer doobies.
Primer doobies.
Primer doobies.
That was a primer doobie.
Ooh, there you go. There's a cop.
It's an expectorant.
It is. Yeah, now, for those who don't understand what an expectorant is, look it up. It's marijuana and two other plants on the planet are expectorants.
And it's actually very healthy.
Very healthy. It's because we live in a toxic environment. Because we live in an environment where we have factories and we have cars and, you know, it's not as clean as it could be. Those chemicals get stuck to the tar that is in the marijuana. See, they didn't lie to us on that one. There is more tar in weed than in cigarettes. But the cilia in your lungs are water. They shouldn't stick together.
but an expectorant will force stuff out of your lungs.
Absolutely,
everything bad.
And that's what makes you cough. Yeah. That's a good thing.
It is. But unfortunately, smokers out there don't think that the pot's helping you, because unfortunately, even though it's an expectorant...
Well, the nicotine freezes those cilia hairs from doing their job, which is right. pushing the gunk out of your lungs.
And it's the fiberglass makes your lungs bleed to draw the nicotine in more. And
oh, excellent.
While the cilia is water-based and doesn't bond with tar, blood and tar do bond together. So when you make your lungs bleed by smoking the cigarettes and then you smoke your expectorant, unfortunately that tar gets caught up in the scar tissue and it can't do its job. So lots of weed, but quit smoking the cigarettes.
Moral of the story is cigarettes are very bad.
Very bad. Very, very bad.
Yeah. Don't mix your weed with tobacco either. No. That's a bad idea.
It is. It's a terrible idea.
It's just
idea.
As bad as smoking cigarettes.
Yeah, it is. It's worse. Again,
well, you're exposing a marijuana to it as well.
No, you're increasing the tar content because there is more tar in the marijuana itself. But the tar is what makes it an expectorant because tar itself doesn't bond to the water that is 80% of the cilia. It's the simple science, people. You got to think about what they tell you. They tell you parts of the truth. You got to put it together.
This joint is crazy.
This joint is really making
still
talk to
at least a quarter joint there.
Next time we at do least. This, we need a clock, a timer.
We also need a fourth.
How long
did
it take to roll?
I guess we kind of do on the camera, but...
People need to know this shit.
We need another person as well.
Oh, we got
Cameraman. We do have cameraman. We cut him out a couple times. Sorry, cameraman. You get so used to the camera being around.
Awesome.
It's like it's just the camera. Yeah. You are a person, we apologize.
You just gotta like pretend it's not there.
Yeah.
Pretend.
This is, like, can you get a good look at this? This is
so resonated.
But it burns great.
I think it's the resin is a nice slow burn on itself now. I really don't know how much of the weed's making that burn.
We don't have to clear it out every time.
Nope. By the ash. It's pretty white.
Rotations
to
now.
Burn by itself.
Clean ash, well. Though.
Oh, incredible.
And it didn't run like crazy.
Here.
Just don't knock the cherry out.
That is very clean ash.
White as white can be.
Beautiful. Well, again, that's just a tribute to your skill at what you do, my friend.
Oh, thank you.
And, of course, to the maker of the goo goodness and the... Other extracts
all
have gone
extracts
in.
Involved?
Yeah, there's nothing in there that's adding impurities. You can see that.
No, it's just plain psycho. Oh. Psycho.
I will rate this as the best joint I have smoked so far.
Best joint today, that's for sure.
I'm not saying today.
Yeah,
I'm saying
agree with you, Chris.
This is the best joint I have smoked. It's very rare that you get a supercharged joint that burns like this one has. That tastes like this one did, and that, you know, right up until the end hasn't really made you choke, but now it's getting that thick resin, and even I'm choking on my hoots.
Just made me choke.
Oh, I know, and I know I'm going to cough on this one right now when it comes.
Maybe it's your fault, you just planted the seed with them.
I did,
there.
Psychosomatic choking. Happens.
Thanks.
It's all my fault. I will take responsibility.
I think I might have taken too big of a toke.
See, no, that was even a big toke. We're at that
it's
point.
It's contagious now.
It's,
you're doing
it's
it.
Handle it's handle with care.
Yeah, it is. It's start taking the smaller puffs now.
Okay, smaller puffs.
Respect the doobie. That's where we're at.
Holy shit.
That was good.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Now, for those who've seen his videos, I win bong smoking competitions. I don't choke. This is worth pulling that cough out.
It's a hard joint to smoke. It really is.
And you know what? It's slowing down.
It is.
It's just turning
it's taking longer.
Brown, resiny chunk.
Now I think we're going to get another 5 minutes of smoking. We can't take the toots anymore.
Mm-hmm.
No, exactly. I think we're just pulling in the slipstream now.
So good. Can't believe it.
Yeah, you can't be greedy anymore.
Smooth.
Oh, but it's still so tasty.
Usually,
when you get a cough gets pulled out of you like that, it's accompanied by a rough taste.
Yeah.
This isn't. It's accompanied by a very nice taste. It's just so thick.
It is thick.
ready to vegetate.
Holy fuck, that is the most insane joint ever.
Hands class. Kudos, team.
Definitely my
thank
top,
you very much for
three.
The invite.
You know what? It's like dabbing. Each toke is like dabbing. It's not even like a joint.
No, you're, and you know what? I wouldn't be far off to say that's what you're doing, but even
it's
more.
It's a dab joint.
But it's a double decker. Like, as Enrico from the Sublimator likes to call him, the double decker, when he takes his marijuana with a little bit of hash in the screen and then he puts the butter in through the top there.
That'd be a triple decker.
That's what I think too, but he's just got two, one's one stack and the other one comes in.
Yeah, but there's
top,
three so things, so that'd be triple. He might be bad at math. He's good at creating things, but
awesome,
he's bad at accounting. I don't know. Maybe he was high when he came up with that kind of reasoning.
Well, I bet he was. He's high most of the time.
He is.
He invented the Sublimator.
See, that's what the Sublimator does to you. It destroys you, kind of like this joint.
Yes. Actually, I'd like to send a shout out to Enrico and a thank you for the Sublimator. I still use mine daily. It is an awesome toy. See, that's my...
You got the hat on.
I got the hat.
I got
the
shirt.
I do enjoy the product. So much so that I endorse something I didn't make.
We all like the product. I
love
got one
the
too.
Product. It's amazing.
Darcy, you got to get one.
Yeah, I got to get one too. I used it at the on the actual boat cruise.
Right.
And they work fantastic.
You're going to join the Sublimator Club then? Mm-hmm.
Well, I've sent him a message. I'm just waiting for him to get back to me. I'm hoping to be able to provide them. And until that point, I know that you can get them at iMedicate in Vancouver. They're selling them right now.
Well, this joint is pretty much done. Take a look at that.
Amazing.
That was nuts.
It's finally over?
I haven't been this
I'll have another one.
Since I was 13 or 14 years old.
Almost time to roll another joint. In the meantime, keep watching Urban Grower and Urban Ramo for more weed videos.